When you think of 3D printed furniture, do you think of big, blobby, bulky plastic furniture that you really wouldn't want in your home? That's what I think of. So today, I'm inviting you to join me on my journey to find a way to make beautiful 3D printed furniture that you and I would be proud to have in our homes. Hi, I'm Ken of Rist Innovations, and I have over 40 years of woodworking experience and several years of 3D printing experience. So let's get wild and crazy and solve the puzzle of how to create beautiful 3D printed furniture. So let's get started. First, the design. Now, there are quite a few woodworkers that are using 3D printers in their shops to create jigs and fixtures to help them organize their shops and make it easier to build traditional wood furniture. The Swedish Maker's YouTube channel is a great example of this. Link in the description. But I haven't seen anybody actually 3D print a piece of furniture and use real wood to complement it using common woodworking techniques. So that's what we're going to attempt to do today. The first question is, what type of piece of furniture should I design? I have several self-imposed requirements. Number one, simple design using traditional woodworking assembly techniques. Number two, ready to assemble or flat pack to make it easy to take apart and to ship or move. Number three, the furniture would be 3D printed, but I would add real wood so that it would look like a traditional piece of wood furniture. And number four, I would finish the piece using wipe-on polyurethane. It's my guess that most of my subscribers are more experienced with 3D printing rather than woodworking, so you may feel you need more woodworking experience before you attempt this project. However, I have the answer for you. This brings me to the sponsor of today's video, Woodworkers Guild of America. Whether you are interested in basic woodworking techniques, hand tools, furniture making, or how to make a special jig, Woodworkers Guild of America is your online resource for woodworking instructions, ideas, and information. They have over 1,000 instructional videos taught by professional instructors that walk you through each technique with step-by-step demonstrations. Even though I have over 40 years woodworking experience, I am still constantly learning, and I have recently enjoyed watching some of their videos on furniture making and veneering. As a special offer, the first 1,000 people that click on the link below in the video description and join will get a full year of premium membership for only $1.49. I promise you that this is a fantastic deal, and it costs less than a cup of coffee. Just a note, this special offer is for new members only. As a member, you also have access to Woodworkers Guild of America live streaming, where their expert instructors share their tips and answer questions with Woodworkers Guild of America community in real time. If this sounds like something you would be interested in, please click on the link in the description below. Thanks again for Woodworkers Guild of America for sponsoring this video. Now, back to the show. I decided to keep it simple to prove out the concept, so I started sketching some different end tables for my living room. Using Fusion 360, I came up with this three-legged end table design that includes attractive tapered curved legs and a 1-inch thick round top. I designed the legs 3/4 inch thick to simulate standard 3/4 stock such as plywood or solid wood. The overall size of the end table is 24 inches high and it has a 15 inch diameter top. Next, I needed to design the end table so it could be taken apart. So I came up with this concept of using M6 screws, threaded inserts, and 3D printed dowels. I went through several versions of the triangular shaped centerpiece before I finalized this design. I added these holes to make it easier to get an Allen wrench inside to tighten and loosen the M6 screws. After that, I needed to cut the end table up into smaller pieces so they could be printed in my 3D printer. I designed each leg into 3 pieces and the top into 4 quadrants with the goal to assemble them together using 3D printed alignment dowels and 3D gloop adhesive. I planned to print all the parts using my Bamboo Lab X1C printer, so I was limited to a build volume of 256 mm cubed. So, How could I use real wood to make the 3D printed parts look like real wood? The answer? Use real walnut veneer that has a pressure sensitive adhesive on the back. I can buy the walnut veneer in either 2 foot by 8 foot or 4 foot by 8 foot sizes. So they would be plenty big enough to cover my end table and then some. An added requirement I made for myself is I didn't want to hand cut all the walnut veneer pieces from the large sheets of veneer because it would take a long time to cut them out with a utility knife. My solution? Use my Algo Laser laser engraver. The good news is that the 22 watt diode laser engraver that won't have any problems cutting this thin veneer, which is about 1 millimeter thick. The bad news is that the standard Algo Laser work area is only 400 millimeters by 400 millimeters, which is too small for the end table legs. And I definitely didn't want a seam in the middle of the legs by combining two pieces of veneer. The good news is that Algo Laser sells an extender upgrade that allows you to increase the work area to 400 millimeters by 850 millimeters long. So I ordered the extenders and built the sliding shelf to hold the expanded laser engraver. I came up with this clever idea to combine a Creality laser enclosure and an Algo Laser laser enclosure so that I can have access to the entire 400 by 850 millimeter work area. And as an added safety precaution, I exhaust the fumes to the outside using a powerful inline exhaust fan. Next, 3D printing the parts. I decided to 3D print the end table parts in glass-filled ABS because I wanted the end table to be strong and I didn't want to worry about it turning into mush if it was left in a hot car. So that's why I didn't print it in something like PLA. I used 0.28 millimeter layer height because I didn't care about layer lines because everything would be covered up with the walnut veneer. I printed the parts with 5 layers, walls, and tops and bottoms with 25% triangle sparse infill pattern. Originally, I designed the legs into 3 pieces, and then I also had 3 apron pieces. But I thought, why not combine the upper leg with the apron? So I eliminated 1 joint in each leg. It took me about 40 hours and a little less than 2 spools of filament to print all the parts. I dry fit all the parts just to make sure everything would go together properly before I began gluing up the legs and the top pieces together. So far, so good. Next, laser cutting the veneer. While I was 3D printing the end table parts, I turned my attention back to the laser cutter. I used a special software add-on that allowed me to convert Fusion 360 sketches into SVG files, which is needed for the laser cutter. I used Lightburn software to nest all the parts on the veneer panels. Speaking of veneer panels, I cut a quantity of 4 pieces of walnut veneer, 400 millimeters by 850 millimeters for the end table. One thing I didn't mention before is that the circumference of the 15-inch diameter top is almost 1200 millimeters long, which is longer than the 850 millimeter Algo Laser work area. I didn't want to cut 2 pieces and have a butt joint because I was concerned that the stress of the joint might cause the adhesive to pull away over time. Plus, I didn't want to see the joint. To solve this problem, I came up with an overlapping design similar to what is used for traditional shaker boxes. Shaker boxes were designed by a religious sect in New England in the 1800s called the Shakers, and they used these boxes to hold seeds and other miscellaneous things. I've built shaker boxes in the past, so I thought this would be an attractive feature for the top. I used copper rivets to finish the look, which you'll see in the assembly section of this video. So now that all the 3D printed parts are done printing and the walnut veneer has been laser cut, it's time for assembly. First, I needed to assemble the 3 pieces of each leg to form 1 full leg, and I needed to repeat this for the other 2 legs. I used the ABS 3D printed alignment dowels and 3D gloop adhesive, especially designed for ABS. Link is in the description below. I assembled each leg using this clever clamping design, which is based in Europe. A series of 20 millimeter diameter holes are drilled 96 millimeters apart to form this grid. There are many companies in Europe that sell these bench dogs and related parts. I made this custom work table using a special drilling jig that I had bought. Next, I assembled the tabletop, first gluing two quadrants together to form two half diameters. Then I cut these forms on the bandsaw to help in gluing the two half diameters to form the full tabletop. Next, I used wood filler to fill the seams on the legs and the tabletop because I didn't want the seams to show through when I attached the walnut veneer. Then I sanded all the parts to blend in the seams and rough up the plastic surface so the veneer will have a good texture to bond to the plastic. I used gloves, a dust mask, and a dust collector to control the dust because I didn't want to breathe the plastic and glass dust from the sanding. I wiped all the parts so they were clean and now ready to apply the veneer. Now, the tricky part is to attach the walnut veneer to the 3D printed parts. The reason why it's tricky is because the pressure sensitive adhesive on the back of the walnut veneer is very aggressive. So I will only get one chance to align the veneer pieces to the corresponding 3D printed part. I came up with this series of clever 3D printed fixtures that will allow me to secure the legs and top to a piece of plywood. These adjustable stops allowed me to center the oversized veneer pieces over the 3D printed parts. I carefully cut the protective liner from the back of the veneer and placed the veneer into the alignment fixtures and applied the veneer to the 3D printed parts. Initially, I used this veneer roller to make the initial contact, but then I used this special veneer scraper that has a plastic blade, which allowed me to place a much higher force on the veneer, which is needed for the pressure-sensitive adhesive to bond with the ABS plastic. I wanted to speed up the veneer trimming process, so I installed this flush trimming bit on my table router, and I was able to quickly trim off the excess walnut veneer from the 3D printed parts. Next, I placed the thin strips of walnut veneer to the edges of all the 3D printed parts. To install the edge banding to the edge of the tabletop, it was critical to center the edge banding because the shaker dovetail feature needed to be centered. So I 3D printed these discs to elevate the top, and I used the surface of the workbench as a reference, and this worked out perfectly. Next, I used this edge banding trim tool, which has a razor blade inside, to trim off the excess walnut veneer. Then I sanded all the parts, first with 120 grit sandpaper, then with 150 grit sandpaper, and then finally with 220 grit sandpaper. I added copper rivets to the tabletop shaker feature for a special touch. The next important step is to apply the finish. I used this Watco brand satin wipe-on polyurethane. It's important to apply the polyurethane in a well-ventilated area, and as an added protection, I wore my respirator. I applied four coats, allowing about 4 hours of dry time between coats, and I sanded between each coat using 220 grit sandpaper. It normally takes about 24 hours after the final coat for the polyurethane to fully cure. Then I attached the three legs to the triangle module using the ABS dowels and M6 screws. Next, I attached the tabletop to the legs using three ABS dowels and one M6 screw. Finally, I added these small 3D printed plugs to hide these screw access holes. Are you ready for the final reveal? And here it is, the finished round end table in its final home in my living room. I consider this a resounding success because I accomplished my dream of designing and building a 3D printed piece of furniture, combining it with real walnut wood veneer to create a stunning piece of furniture that I am proud to have in my living room. And I hope you feel the same way. This end table is much lighter than one made from particle board or MDF. And the threaded inserts melted into the plastic are much stronger than the fittings you would normally see in a typical ready-to-assemble furniture, such as offered by companies that sell Swedish meatballs. Let me know what you think of this process in the comments below. Also, please give me a thumbs up if you liked the video. I think this concept is the tip of the iceberg because I plan to make more furniture pieces using these techniques. So please consider subscribing to my channel if you'd like to see more. Last question. If I was to develop a line of furniture that you could 3D print, and if I was to offer my STL files and a pre-cut veneer package for sale that also included all the accessory hardware, would you be interested? Please let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Bye.